Hey, John Sanmez from SimpleProgrammer.com. So I got a question here about being in the right path here. And this question is from Brett. And Brett says, hello, John. I've been listening to your podcast and I've really enjoyed it. I have a question for you. Episode 19 was an episode I could relate to. The last few years, I've been mainly a support developer. I've been in the corner by myself and being quiet and mainly supporting web form apps, and my skills have plateaued. I'm now in the process of trying to right the ship. I'd like to get my career back on track and become more of a senior level developer. I'm also transitioning from back-end dev to more of a front-end slash JavaScript developer. I've been working on tutorials on Pluralsight, CodeSchool, and I've been reading various books and blogs. As far as improving my soft skills, I've recently joined Toastmasters, and I've been doing that for a month. What would you consider some good tests or metrics to determine if I'm on track? Would you have any other suggestions on how to reach this goal? Thanks, Brett. So Brett, this is obviously tough to judge if you're on track. I mean, you said that your goal is to get your career back on track and become more of a senior level developer. So as far as tests and metrics to judge against this, in order to do that, you need to have sort of some concrete goals in place, because you're not really just, I mean, you can kind of, you know, hold your finger up to the wind and say, am I going the right direction? And you can kind of get a feel for it. But if you really want to, you know, make measurable progress, you need measurable goals. So what I would suggest is, and I'm a big fan of trusting the process, which means that you can't force things to happen. You can't force results, but what you can do is you can come up with a process and you can judge how well that you follow that process, hoping that it will lead you to the results that you want. So that's what I would suggest for you, is basically, you know, look at the different things that you want to do. So like one metric that I've always used in my career is, at one point I said I need to read one technical book every month. That was to advance my career. Again, I can't guarantee that that's going to make me so much of a better developer, but that's a good process that will probably result in that outcome. And it's something I can measure. I can say, yes, I passed, or no, I failed. I didn't do it this month. So come up with things like that. You know, if you did the Toastmasters, that's good. Maybe you have some number of things that you're gonna do every month that's going to move you in that positive direction. Maybe you even have some concrete goals, like I'm going to learn this programming language in order to be able to build this application. So you can judge your progress on that, or you're gonna read so many pages. You're gonna do something that's all measurable. Another thing that I would say is that you should measure some goals that might be a little bit further out. So for example, maybe you have this goal of being a senior developer. Well, so go from that goal that's pretty far out and work backwards from it and say, what milestones do I need to reach in order to get there? And so you know, you can measure yourself as you hit those milestones. That tells you that you're on the right path. But you know, it's good what you're doing. I mean, you're making an actual conscious effort to improve your career, and that's going to result in some positive things, so long as you get this measurement point right. And you know, some of it might even just be devoting an hour a day to improving yourself, you know, self-development activities, and that's you're going to see measurable progress over time. So you know, it's really personal to figure out what your metrics are, but like I said, I would just focus on picking out the things that are about the process. You control the process, you can put it into place, but you can't control the results. You can only do the right thing, and then the results have to take care of themselves. Now, if you don't get results from the process you're following, then you change your process. But as far as metrics and measuring yourself and holding yourself accountable, don't hold yourself accountable to results, which are more difficult and you can't have direct control over. Instead, hold yourself accountable to a process that you put in place for yourself, and that's how you're gonna find success and you're gonna make a lot of progress. And sometimes you'll go down wrong paths, but that's fine. It's you'll figure it out over time. So anyway, thanks for the question. I think this is a really good question. And if you like these videos, if you like this podcast, definitely subscribe, and I'll talk to you next time. Take care.